Myself, Asma Kausar Sheikh, lecturer in Mechanical Engineering, JPT Warangal. So today we are going to design our shops. So here, in previous class, we was discussed about the design of solid shaft and hollow shaft on the basis of the strength. When shafts are subjected to twisting moment in separately and solid shaft for solid shaft. So here we discussed. We discussed already all these things. So just to, we'll recap it. For the solid shaft, torque equal to pi by 16 into tau into d cube. So when it is subjected to twisting moment or torque only. From this, so you can find the diameter of the shaft when you know torque and shear stress. So this is the equation to find the diameter of the shaft when it is subjected to twisting moment or torque. For hollow shaft, it is torque equal T equal to pi by 16 into tau into DO cube. So DO is the outer diameter into 1 minus K power 4. So K is the DI by DO. DI is nothing but inner diameter of the hollow shaft. DO is outer diameter of the hollow shaft. So K equal to DI by DO. So it is when the shaft is subjected to torque or twisting moment only. So next when the shafts are subjected to bending moment only, for solid shaft, M equal to pi by 32 into sigma b into d cube. So M is bending moment, sigma b is the bending stress, d is diameter here. So from this equation, you can find the diameter of the shaft when you know the bending moment and sigma b. For a hollow shaft, so M equal to pi by 32 into sigma b into DO cube into 1 minus k power 4. So k value is DI by DO. As I said, DO is the outer diameter of the shaft, DI is inner diameter of the shaft. So here, next important one is power transmitted by the shaft. P equal to 2 pi nt by 60. So from this, if power and speed of the shaft is given, from this you can find the torque. So you can substitute the torque in that previous problem. Here, torque is in Newton meter and the speed is in RPM. So for the same shaft, for the same material of both the shafts, DO cube into 1 minus k power 4 equal to d cube. For the same material, if you want to replace the solid shaft with the hollow shaft, this is the formula. DO cube into 1 minus k power 4 equal to d cube. For in case of belted rise, the twisting moment is given by T equal to T1 minus T2 into R. T1 is the tension on the tight side of the belt. Then T2 is tension on the slack side of the belt. R is the radius of the pulley. So next, design of solid shaft and hollow shaft on basis of strength when the shaft subjected to combined twisting moment and bending moment. The next one is when shaft is subjected to combined twisting moment and bending moment. So here, there is no exact, we cannot find exactly the stresses. So that's why here we will go with the theory of failures, that is two theories. One is Gauss theory and the Rankine's theory here. Gauss theory is also called as maximum shear stress theory. So this is used for the ductile materials, tau max equal to half into sigma b square plus 4 tau square. So tau is the shear stress induced due to twisting and sigma b is the bending moment, bending stress or tensile bending stress, that is, that may be tensile or compressive. Induced due to bending. Here, for the gust theory, we need to find first equivalent twisting moment TE equal to under root of m square plus t square, that is equal to pi by 16 into tau into d cube. So for the gust theory, first we need to find the equivalent twisting moment and then we need to find the diameter of the shaft. So here the maximum normal stress theory as Rankine's theory, the equivalent bending moment ME equal to, here for the Rankine's theory is called as maximum normal stress theory. So this is used for the brittle materials. So then ME equal to half into M plus under root of M square plus T square. This is the equivalent bending moment, that is equal to pi by 32 sigma B into D cube. So now in this chapter, we are going to design some shafts, some problems. So that is based on, that is either a solid or hollow shaft and base of strength. When the shafts are subjected to twisting or torque only, when the shafts are subjected to bending moment only, when the shaft subjected to combined twisting and bending moment. So first we'll see one problem. A solid shaft is transmitting 1 megawatt at 240 rpm. Determine the diameter of the shaft if the maximum torque transmitted exceeds the mean torque by 20%. Take the maximum allowable shear stress as 60 newton per mm square. So here it is a solid shaft which is transmitting a power of 1 megawatt. Power is 1 megawatt, that is 10 to the power of 6 watts. At 240 rpm, that is speed is 240. And here we need to find the diameter. So here the mean torque is, maximum torque is 20% the mean torque. So take the maximum allowable shear stress as 60 newton per mm square. So here power is given, power equal to 1 into 10 to the power of 6 watts. Speed is 240 rpm. So the maximum torque is 20% above the mean torque, means 100 plus 20. So 120% of mean torque, nothing but 1.2 times the mean torque. The maximum torque is 1.2 times the mean torque. And shear stress is 60 newton per mm square. So here what we get, the torque is the mean torque. So we need to multiply with 1.2 to get the maximum torque. So diameter of the shaft is D. Then mean torque is transmitted by the shaft. That is T equal to P into 60 by 2 pi N. So P is 1 into 10 to the power of 6. So here directly converted into Newton mm. So 10 to the power of 6 into 10 cube into 60 by 2 pi into 240. N is 240 rpm. So that is equal to, so when you do this, you'll get 39,784 into 10 cube Newton mm. So this is a mean torque. Here we take maximum torque. So that's why what we need to do is we need to multiply the mean torque with maximum. So the mean torque with 1.2. So when you multiply mean torque with 1.2, then it is 4,047,741 into 10 cube Newton mm is the maximum torque. So as we know, torque equal to T max equal to pi by 16 into tau into D cube. So tau value is 60. So that's why you just substitute the values here. Then we'll get the D value as 159.4, that is 160 mm. So this is the diameter of the shaft. So here the simple one is when the mean torque is the maximum torque is 1.2 times the mean torque, means so you need to take 20% more than a mean torque, means you need to add 20% to the mean torque. So here that is 1.2 times the mean torque. So this is what the first problem. So next problem is a hollow steel shaft is 225 mm outside diameter and 150 mm inside diameter, and calculate the maximum power this shaft can transmit at 150 rpm if the maximum shear stress is not to exceed 70 mega Newton per meter square. So here outside diameter is given, inside diameter is given, speed is given, and shear stress is given. What we need to do is we need to find the power. So it is the reverse process for the process of the last problem. First, what we need to do is we need to find the torque, then you need to substitute in the power form. So speed is given, that is 150 rpm, and DO is given, that is 225 mm, DI is given, that is 150 mm, and shear stress is given, that is 70 Newton per mm square. So here the torque formula is torque equal to pi by 16 into tau into DO power 4 by DO into 1 minus DI by DO power 4. So we just substitute the values in this formula, then what we get is we get the torque. So torque, that is pi by 16 into 70 into DO is 225, so, and DI is 150. Just substitute the values in this formula, what we get the torque? The torque equal to 125.633 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm. So that is converted into kilo Newton meter. So then it is 125.633 kilo Newton meter. So here power equal to 2 pi nt by 60. So 2 pi into n is 150 rpm. Torque is 125.633 by 60, then it is 1973.44 kilowatts is the power. So next one is a problem number 3, that is a shaft made of mild steel is required to transmit 100 kilowatt at 300 rpm. The supported length of the shaft is 3 meters. It carries two pulleys, each weighing 1500 newtons, supported at distance of 1 meter from the ends respectively. Assume the safe value of the stress. Determine the diameter of the shaft. So here the shaft is transmitting the power that is 10 kilowatt at 300 rpm, and it carries two pulleys of each weighing 1500 newtons. Means here the shaft is subjected to combined torque as well as bending moment. So torque because of the power transmission and bending moment because of the pulleys. So here you need to take the which theory we need to take means it is the mild steel. Mild steel is nothing but it is ductile material. So which theory we use means we use Gauss theory. So power is given, that is 100 into 10 cube watts. Speed is given, that is 300 rpm, and length is 3 meters, and weight of the pulleys is 1500 newtons. So this is the formula, the shaft which carries a two pulleys, so 1 meter from the ends. So this is the formula, this is the beam diagram. It is like simply supported beam. So here we need to find torque and bending moment, and for the Gauss theory we need to find the equivalent twisting moment, and then need to substitute in the formula. So to find the torque, first to find the bending moment, so reactions at each RA and RB is, here it is 1500 and here it is also 1500. So the maximum bending moment M equal to 1500 into 1. So the maximum bending moment will be at C and D. So that's why it is 1500 into 1. So the diameter of the shaft D, we know that equivalent twisting moment E equal to 3519. So here you need to find the torque. So when you find the torque, how can we find torque equal to 2 pi n t by 60. From this, torque equal to P into 60 by 2 pi, P into 60 by 2 pi n. So when you substitute the value P and N, you will get the torque, that is, so 3183, and for the bending moment, maximum bending moment is 1500 into 1. So that is, when you substitute these values in the formula, you will get 3519 newton meter. So here that has to be converted into newton mm. When it is converted into newton mm, we need to multiply with 10 cube. So Gauss theory is TE equal to pi E by 16 into tau into D cube. So tau is 60. TE is 3519 into 10 cube. So then D value is 66.8, that is 70 mm. So this is what the diameter of the shaft. So here in this formula, first you need to find which when it has both twisting and bending moment, you need to go with either Gauss theory or Rankine's theory. So here it is a mild steel. Mild steel is ductile material, so that's why when it is a ductile material, you need to go for Gauss theory. So that is now maximum shear stress theory. So that is, for that what we need to do is we need to find the equivalent twisting moment. To find equivalent twisting moment, we need to know torque and when we want to find the torque, we need to P equal to, we use the formula P equal to pi T by 60. From that, you need to find torque and you need to solve the beam equation then for finding maximum bending moment. So when you get both torque as well as bending moment, just substitute in the formula and you'll get the diameter of the shaft. So next we'll see the normally asked questions in the exam. A hollow shaft for a rotary compressor is to be designed to transmit a maximum torque of 4750 Newton meter. The shear stress in the shaft is limited to 50 Newton per mm square. Find the outside and inside diameter of the shaft. If the ratio of the inside and outside diameter of the shaft is 0.4. So here we need to find inside and outside diameter of the shaft. Inside and outside diameter of the shaft. So here it is only, the shaft is only subjected to torque. Torque is already given in the form, in the problem, and shear stress is given and K value is given. So then first we need to find the, so directly P equal to pi by 16 into tau into DO cube into 1 minus K power 4. So K value is there, torque is given, shear stress is given. So directly we find DO, from that we can find DI. So next question is, a shaft 3 meter long, 70 mm diameter, is subjected to a torque of 2500 Newton meter and carries a pulley at its center weighing 2 kilonewtons. Determine the maximum shear stress induced as it is, it has simply supported. So here the shaft is, diameter is given. We need to find the maximum shear stress induced. So for that, tau max first. So it is subjected to both torque and bending moment. So already torque is given, bending moment can be finded out. So it is simply supported with the center 2 kilonewtons means WL by 4. You will get the maximum bending moment. From this, we can find the equivalent twisting moment. So from that, already diameter of the shaft is given. So we can find the maximum shear stress induced. So next one is, a shaft is supported with two ball bearings and carries a central load of 800 newtons, is to transmit 6 kilowatt running at 100 rpm. The distance between the centers of bearings is 2.5 meters. and the allowable tensile stress is 40 newton per mm square. Determine the size of the shaft. So here it is also same. It has combined bending moment and twisting moment. So you need to find the twisting moment and bending moment, and then so there already see as allowable tensile stress is given. So that's why here what we need to use is we need to use Rankine Stress because here it is given as tensile stress. So equivalent bending moment has to find. Equivalent bending moment equal to half into m plus under root of m square plus t square. So from this you need to find the equivalent bending moment and so after finding the equivalent bending moment, so you need to substitute in the formula equivalent bending moment equal to pi by 32 into sigma b into d cube. So from that you can find the diameter of the shaft. So next question is, a mild steel shaft transmits 23 kilowatt at 200 rpm. It carries a central load of 900 newtons and simply supported between the bearings is 2.5 meters apart. Determine the size of the shaft if the allowable shear stress is 42 newton per mm square and the maximum tensile or compressive shear stress is not to exceed 56 newton per mm. So here same as earlier, but here what we need to do is we need to find the same torque. So here power and speed is given so that we can find the torque, and then the center load is given and the distance between the bearings is given. So same WL/4, using WL/4 simply supported with central load, the maximum bending moment is WL/4. So then the formula is W 900 into 2.5/4. You'll get the maximum bending moment. So next, after getting torque and bending moment, here to find the diameter of the shaft. So here both shear stress and tensile stress is given. So you need to find the diameter with Gauss theory, means you need to find equivalent twisting moment. From that you can find the diameter of the shaft. So next, using Rankine theory, that is you need to find the equivalent bending moment. From that you can find the diameter of the shaft. So in both the cases you can find the diameter of the shaft. So whichever is the maximum, that is the diameter of the final diameter of the shaft we need to take. So this is what about the design of shaft based on the strength. So most important one is we need to find whether it is based on the twisting or bending. So most important formula is torque equal to pi by 16 into tau into d cube. So when the torque is directly given, we can use this formula. Otherwise, if the power and speed is given, you need to use the power formula. From that, you need to find the torque and substitute in this formula. So for the hollow shaft is the same. In place of d cube, you need to go with do cube into 1 minus k power 4. So for the bending moment, m equal to pi by 32 into sigma b into d cube. So if it consists only bending moment, means it is only the axial. axle which consists of only rotating parts. There is no rotation in the shaft. So power P equal to 2 pi NT by 60. So here, if the power is in watts, so torque will be in Newton meters. So in certain cases, if the belt drives were used, then torque equal to T1 minus T2 into R. So when both combined twisting and shear stress, twisting and bending moment is there, we need to use either Gauss theory or Prankes theory. So Gauss theory is for the ductile materials and Prankes theory is for the brittle materials. In the Gauss theory, we need to find equivalent twisting moment T equal to under root of m square plus T square. For the Gauss theory, Prankes theory, we need to find equivalent bending moment, that is half into m plus under root of m square plus t square. So using these two, either of these two, we can find the diameter of the shaft. So this is what the this is how we need to design the shaft based on the strength.